You know, one of the things I like about this gig here in Branson is I don't have to travel. I mean, you folks do all the traveling, and it's kind of fun for you because you don't have to do it all the time. But in my business, if you don't have a sit-down gig like this, you got to get up every day just about and go somewhere else. And after years on the road, you run into problems that you remember. One problem in particular bugged me for years. I got a song about it. Let me sing it for you. It goes like a one, two, a one, two, three, ho. When you get a haircut, be sure to go back home. When you get a haircut, get a barber you have known since you were a little bitty boy sitting in a booster chair. Or you might look like Larry Moore or Curly if a stranger cuts your hair. Well, Butte, Montana just passing through. One thing I just had to do, had to get a haircut. And I was worried for my hair. Had a feeling of impending doom the minute I stepped into that room. Laid my eyes upon that barber chair. It was a macho barber shop. Hair dryers was mounted on a rifle rack. Wasn't no mirrors. Barber chair was a Peterbilt. Barber walks in, he's huge, 7 feet tall, 300 pounds of spring steel rawhide, wearing a hard hat, chewing a cigar, had on t-shirts and I hate musicians. Threw me in the chair, sneered and said, what'll it be, pal? A lot of people be intimidated in a situation like this. I was not. I am what I am. Play my piano, sing my little songs. Hey, I looked him right in the eye and I said, I'm a logger, just in from Coos Bay, Oregon. Been topping trees, quite possibly the toughest man in the entire world. He said, all right. He gave me a haircut, friends. My hair was gone. Made Kojak look like William Lee Golden. Had a tremendous craving to operate heavy equipment. Now, you might think that Butte, Montana haircut's the worst any man could ever get. Wrong. Few months later, I'm in L.A., trucking along on a smoggy day. Hair salon starting to look like Bozo the Clown. Yeah, I'm looking shaggy, not too good. I put it off as long as I could. Hate to get a haircut out of town. The minute I stepped into the shop, I knew this guy's into punk rock. Walls are done in black leather, got chains and whips and handcuffs hanging off of. Barber walks in, he's got orange hair, stainless steel teeth, black leather jacket with zinc studs, black mascara. Threw me in the chair, slapped me a couple times, chained me down, threw a Nazi flag over me, got right down my face and said, I'm gonna tell you something that make you a little nervous. I laughed. I said, what could possibly make me nervous? He said, I'm gay. No problem. Well, I mean, I wasn't threatened in any way. I'm securing my manhood. And what I am. Play my piano, sing my little songs. Looked him right in the eye. I said, I'm a logger. Played football in high school. I was in the Marine Corps. He said, all right. He gave me a haircut. I walked out of there, friends. My hair was purple. Or at least that mohawk section down in the middle was purple. Had a white ponytail on this side. This side looked sort of like Mr. T. Right after a lawnmower accident. Felt a teeny bit conspicuous. Luckily, my next show was up in San Francisco. Got it there, didn't stand out at all. Most people thought it was an insurance salesman. A few months later, I'm way down south. Grits some gravy and a hush your mouth. Hair so long, starting to look like a man in drag. It was then that the sheriff came up and said, hey, boy, got too much hair on that head. Better get yourself a haircut or a dog tag. Well, the minute I stepped into the shop, I knew I was dealing with a born-again barber. see too many barbershops with a steeple. Had an organ in the corner. Choir. Usher lent me the barber chair. Barber walks in, starts saying grace. Oh, Lord, for these haircuts we are about to receive, may we be truly thankful. Dominus, possum, pox, proboscis, postmortem, et tu, brute, puella, barberundum. Sort of a half Baptist, half Catholic. Sort of a Catholicist. Anyway, he put me in the chair, started cutting my hair and preaching at the same time. He's a wild man. Scissors and razors are flying around my head. He's talking about the evils of dancing, drinking, liquor, sex, wild women, and music. Then he looked down at me and said, what do you do for a living? Now, I'm not ashamed of what I do for a living. Work in bars and casinos, around liquor and wild women. Hey, I just play that piano, sing my little songs. Looked him right in the eye and I said, I run this church for loggers. When you get a haircut, be sure to go back home. When you get a haircut, get a barber you have known. Since you were a little bitty boy sitting in a booster chair, or you might look like Larry Moore, curly if a stranger cuts your hair.